Hello, History Hatters. Every day, hundreds pass by 1615 S Street Northwest, but there's no placard outside to identify the important person who once lived here. That is Mary Church Terrell.
Mary was a legendary champion for women's suffrage and civil rights. She is a subject worthy of a much lengthier discussion, but this episode focuses on her neglected connection to DuPont Circle and her struggle to live in the neighborhood.
Mary was born in 1863, the year of the Emancipation Proclamation, and she passed away in 1954, just 2 months after the Supreme Court of the United States decided Brown versus the Topeka Board of Education decision, which is the decision that paved the way for public school desegregation. Within this house, Mary wrote her autobiography, A Colored Woman in a White World.
Within her book, which is considered a classic in African American history, Mary described how she and her husband Robert first moved to Washington in 1890. They rented an apartment for a few years, but when they settled in a house in LaDroite Park, the owners wouldn't sell it to them because of the color of their skin. They experienced numerous incidents where either the owners or real estate agents refused to even show them properties.
Mary wouldn't have ended up in this house at all had she not agreed to pay several thousand dollars over the asking price. The real estate agent initially wouldn't sell the house to her because she was black.
Mary reflected on her troubling experience and those of her neighbors, who were often forced to pay higher rent than Caucasians, proclaiming, "African blood is truly a luxury in the United States for which those who show it or acknowledge it pay dearly indeed." When Mary moved into her DuPont home in 1924, her husband Robert died the following year. Mary continued to live in DuPont for the rest of her life, and despite growing older, Mary only grew bolder in her activism. In 1949, Mary spoke to a crowd in New York saying, "A time comes in the life of a human being and in the life of a group of human beings when patience ceases to be a virtue and becomes an ugly, disgraceful vice." She reminded the crowd, despite their fear of being called agitators, her friend Frederick Douglass was once labeled an agitator. She said, "Most of the injustices have been wiped out because there were people called agitators." On June 8, 1953, this house would have been under siege by those delivering telegrams congratulating Mary on her victory as an 89-year-old agitator whose efforts to end Washington's segregation and public dining facilities resulted in a landmark decision from the Supreme Court of the United States in D.C. versus Thompson. As one of the plaintiffs of the case and the ringleader of agitators, Mary Church Terrell used her remaining strength to convince the highest court of the land to enforce the anti-segregation laws stemming from the days of her youth. Earlier in her life, Mary helped found the National Association of Colored Women and served as its first president. In 1928, the association moved to a new headquarters just 2 blocks away from Mary's DuPont home.
The headquarters, still located at 1601 R Street Northwest, is where admirers of Mary paid their final respects as she was laid in state in this building before her funeral service at Lincoln Temple Congregational Church nearby.
The association was kind enough to admit me inside their space. As you can see, Mary has a prominent portrait next to a room filled with illustrious women. Mary has a special plaque by the entrance noting her service as the founding president. Click the History Hat logo to subscribe and continue to explore the mysteries of history.